Right, we have certain numericals based on whatever we have studied till now in kinetic theory of gases, okay, and we will continue with them. So the first numerical that comes your way is find the kinetic energy of 8 gram of methane at 27 degree centigrade. Okay, so we know the formula is kinetic energy is equal to 3 by 2, so this is basically kinetic n into 3 by 2 number of moles into R into T, N into 3 by 2 into R T, okay. The value of R is given, T will be how much? 27 plus 273, that's going to be 300 Kelvin, okay. R, the value is given, N, how will you calculate the number of moles? The number of moles will be 8 gram of methane, and what is methane basically? Methane is CH4, correct? So we have here C as 1 into 12 plus 4 into 1. So this is going to be how much? 12 plus 4, that is 16. So number of moles will be 8 by 16, that's 1 by 2, that's 0.5, okay? So here we have, this will be equal to 0.5 into 3 by 2 into 8.314 into how much? 300. So this is going to be the kinetic energy of 8 gram of methane. You can calculate the same, okay? All right, I'm just letting you know how to work these sums out. You will have to get the final answer by yourself, okay? So find the kinetic energy of one molecule of oxygen at 127 degree centigrade, okay? So how do we do this? Here the Boltzmann's constant is given. So we know kinetic energy is equal to 3 by 2 kT, that is Boltzmann's constant, right? Okay, so 127 degree, that is all that has to be converted. So temperature will be how much? 127 plus 273, that's going to be how much? 400. Okay, 400 degree Kelvin. Okay, so kinetic energy will be equal to 3 by 2 into Boltzmann's constant, that is 1.38 into 10 to the power of minus 23 into 400. Make sense? Okay, quick wrap up. Okay, now find the change in kinetic energy of one mole of an ideal gas when temperature changes by 50 degree centigrade. I am going to allow you some time in order to think about it. A very easy sum. Come on, try it on your own. So, see, what is the kinetic energy of one mole? Kinetic energy, we know, 3 by 2 RT, correct? For one mole of a gas, see, we have used it here. So, for one mole, which is basically 1, okay? Kinetic energy, here we are talking about one mole. It basically is N into 3 by 2, but here N is equal to 1. So, this will be temperature change, okay? Now, when the kinetic energy changes by 50 degree centigrade, what will this be? The value of this is going to be T plus 50. Make sense? Okay. Kinetic energy here will be 3 by 2 R2, RT, and when it changes by 50 degree centigrade, it will be 3 by 2 RT. So this will be 3 by 2 RT plus 3 by 2 into 50. So if you subtract this, change in kinetic energy will be equal to 3 by 2 RT plus 50 minus RT. So RT and RT gets cancelled. So this will be 3 by 2 into R into 50. Makes sense? 3 by 2 into, sorry, here we have R as well, right? So if you put the values, you will get the value 3 by 2 into R. The value of R is 8.314 into 50, and this will be joules. Okay? Clear? Okay. At what temperature the kinetic energy will be half of its value at 127 degree centigrade? Okay? So temperature here will be how much? 127 plus 273, that's going to be how much? 400. Okay, so at what temperature the kinetic energy will be half of its value? So kinetic energy now is equal to 3 by 2 RT. Okay, so kinetic energy now will be 3 by 2 RT. Okay. Basically, here nothing is changing. See, if you look at this formula, okay, nothing is changing here. So at what temperature the kinetic energy will be half of its value? So we know that kinetic energy is directly proportional to temperature, okay? So let's say the original kinetic energy is equal to K, okay? So what we can write is KE1 upon KE2 will be equal to T1 by T2. This is T2, that is we what we need to find out. So we can say T2 will be equal to T1 into KE2 upon KE1. Okay. Now, what is the problem here? At what temperature the kinetic energy will be half of its value? So the kinetic energy will be half of its value, which means KE2 will be half of KE. So if let's say this is, so this is half of K. Okay. So where we have T1, T1 which means how much? 400. KE2, that is half of K. K, so this will be 200 Kelvin. At this temperature, this will be the value. Clear? Is this understood? Okay. Please go through this as it will clarify your concepts of solving numericals in this chapter. So there are a lot of numericals that can be framed like this. Okay. You can take a snapshot of the same or make a note of it. Okay. We'll continue with kinetic theory of gases.